It's been a long time, long time. We shouldn't have left you, left you. Without a dope beat. Step two, step two, step two, step two, step, step two, step two.
Don't call it a comeback, America. Your favorite podcast duo talking about music videos from the 80s, 90s, 2000s, and beyond. No, not really from beyond.
Not really.
We're back.
From the 80s.
We're better than ever. It's been a long time since we left you without a dope TRL Friday podcast to step two, step two, step two. I'm TJ. This is Angela.
Hi. You're talking really loud. I think we're good. Okay.
All right. Well, at least the people heard me.
Yeah.
I was calling back. I don't know if you know your hip-hop references.
I know. It's Aaliyah.
Do a lot of recalls.
I heard the Aaliyah thing.
Well, it's not Aaliyah. It's like, I think it's from, I don't know, maybe from...
I think it's a little Timberland.
Well, Timberland is doing an allusion. I want to say it's like, it's a super old... Is it, who's the guy? Is it Rakim?
In TRL Friday discussion, it's Aaliyah, you know what I mean?
You don't know, you got some hip-hop heads, listen. Hip-hop heads, hard to say. Yeah. But, now I got too quiet, and then he's sitting directly in front of a microphone.
Oh.
Angela cares nothing about policy, but it's her podcast. She does what she wants.
I got in trouble because I coughed when we tried to start.
I said, "You ready to go?" She said, "Yeah." I pressed record, and then immediately she goes,
"Can you guys send an email to our Gmail and tell me if you'd mind if I cough on this podcast? I feel like you won't."
What's our email address?
TRLFridayPodcast@gmail.com. I actually check it every day now.
Hell yeah. 2 weeks gone. None the richer. That's a foreshadowing moment. But we got to go back to our normal thing. You know what our normal thing is? Some rockin' theme songs by the one and only Ryan. Craig, play it! Gets my blood boiling.
You added a verse that time.
Yeah.
Live in the studio. Bye, Ryan.
Bye, Ryan. Thanks for showing up.
He comes live every time.
Every time.
But it sucks when we decide not to do it at the last minute, because then he just has to hitchhike home with his guitar.
It's really, really awkward. So it's been 2 weeks. What a wild world we live in.
I know. It was bad. A lot of bad things. We won't talk about the bad things. Not the serious bad things.
Yeah. Those things have been covered plenty. We got nothing insightful to say about them besides it's a bummer. So we'll move on to happier things. What do we got? I want to do some quick recaps of all the weeks we missed.
Yeah. Okay.
Also, if you hear a lot of popping and cracking, Angela is eating carrots, and I had some earlier. They're delicious. Baby carrots.
They're delicious, right?
I heard a fun fact about baby carrots recently.
I don't know anything about them.
About the guy who invented them. Apparently, I mean, he sold carrots, but he had trouble selling, like, the gross, wimpy ones, and there goes Angela again. You know when you, like, stand in front of my microphone, that's how that works, line of sound or something?
Know. Okay.
And sorry if you didn't hear me, Angela leaned directly in front of my mouth.
That sound is like gas, you know, it just fills the space.
But it bounces off.
Did
you know that's how bats see with sound?
I don't know about bats.
I okay. Know. But anyway, the guy who invented baby carrots, I believe he was a carrot seller. Mm-hmm. I don't know if he grew the carrots, but he tried to sell them, that's for damn sure. And he had a problem where all of his shitty carrots that looked like crap, they wouldn't get bought. And he's like, I gotta do something about this.
Shave them down. Does he handcraft? Is each baby carrot handcrafted?
Maybe at one point, or he just created some kind of scooping mechanism with blades that would just like punch out baby-sized carrots, and then he sold them as baby carrots, and that did the trick.
And now baby carrots are better than the...
Smaller portion size.
So who buys themselves big carrots? My mom.
Only Bugs Bunny.
Only my mom. And sometimes she buys baby too.
Carrots aren't very attractive as a vegetable. Are they legumes or a legume?
I don't know shit about those. I don't know what a nut. I know about. I know nuts.
She knows nuts.
Okay, little recap.
Regular old Draymond Green. That's a little bit of NBA Finals.
That's all I know
podcast.
About that.
Last
the
time
NBA
we were here, last time we did a podcast,
kicked.
I believe that the Warriors are playing OKC. Warriors won that series. And the Cavaliers were in the process of just rolling into the finals. They swept until they got to the finals, and now they're playing tonight, right now.
I feel like no one cares about these finals. I sure as hell don't.
I'm very interested, but it looks like they're turning around. Looks like they're coming to the
finals.
We haven't
been really watching them, so. I'm
sorry that you guys have to listen to this NBA talk, but it's good for you. You can make some awful small talk when that a really annoying dude at your office just asks you questions that, well, he should know that you don't care about sports because you've never talked about sports before.
Just say. They'll talk at you, and then you just, every once in a while, say, man, Steph Curry.
Yeah.
And Draymond Green. Those nuts. That's all you need to
That's
know.
It.
Talking you, points for these finals.
Just make some jokes about Draymond Green kicking people in the dick. Does a lot of that recently.
In fact, kick your office mate in the dick and say, Draymond Green, ya.
Yeah. And then say, guys, serve a 1-game suspension and then go home early.
Yeah.
Take a day off. It's paid.
No, I bet it's not.
I don't think he was paid that game.
Yeah. You can't get paid for kicking someone in the nuts.
Someone said the other day that, like, what the money that of just, like, the max players and people who get all that money and get tons of money, and I mean, in the NBA at least, that every game is, like, $30,000 for them. Can you imagine getting paid $30,000 to play 1 game of basketball? It's so much money.
I would play pretty hard, except for I know the way the contract works. I'd get paid even if I didn't, so. I am a lawyer, though.
Yeah. I don't exactly know how the contracts work in basketball. Contracts confusing things. That's why we need lawyers. I really understood lawyers.
I wish I was a sports agent, but I wouldn't do NBA. I would only do baseball.
Why? So you can hang out with Bryce?
Ichiro.
Oh, Ichiro. Shout out Ichiro. What happened? Recent news, not even from 2 weeks ago. This is pretty new.
Ichiro.
I'll tell everybody quickly about the Ichiro gossip.
He's my favorite player.
Which is a really cool, Drew and I both agree, it's a very, very cool...
Thanks, Drew and TJ.
...player to be your favorite player.
1 second. Okay.
I'm just gonna bring in a break. We're eating baby carrots, broccoli, and those are two separate things.
I don't want any more of the crackers.
And then I found a Giant brand version of Cheez-Its, and Giant makes the white cheddar version of Cheez-Its, and they're a fine substitute, I'll say it. And they're like $1.50 cheaper. Like, that adds up over time.
Oh, and it's a huge-ass box. Man, I spend 50 cents a day when I want to get a snack at work and I buy white cheddar cheese. That guy spent 50 cents on a little mini bag.
It's not bad, though.
I should just bag them here, but...
Yeah, we got them.
Well...
Why don't they make more stronger reusable Ziploc bags? I hate wasting them.
Tell me about it. Ziploc bags have gotten worse. They used to be better, now they're worse.
They're cheaper.
It's like no one uses them or something, so they don't.
Is it because we buy Giant brand and those aren't as strong as Ziploc?
No, man, I've tried all sorts of them.
Do you ever wonder how, like, big name brand things actually sell? Because most people I know just exclusively buy whatever, unless it's like a special item.
They're
but
cheap,
if it's like something
yeah.
like trash bags, why is it? Who's buying like? Oh, I need to get my Glad scented
trash bags. Well, a lot of stores don't have
their
own brand, but a lot of people, man.
I guess if you were one of those cool kids who lives in New York. You always go to your bodega. They don't have a name brand. That would be really cool. Or a store brand, bodega one, or Johnny's.
You know, where you live, the urban life too.
We live a weird DC.
Boston has grocery stores too. New York has grocery stores, but.
Oh, but like DC's just weird in that like since it's come back up and they've thrown money at it, you get a lot of the comforts of the suburbs, but crammed into.
I bet fucking Whole Foods doesn't have store brand trash bags because they don't care.
I bet their store brand is just like better and more expensive than the other one.
I bet it's made out of organic pig poop.
Ugh.
And then, like, it's not fed hormones or something.
Yeah.
Stretched into a bag. All right. Recap. Graduation theme 2 weeks ago. Mr. Eagle pulled away.
Hell yeah.
29.
Eagle Cherry. The name's Cherry. Eagle Cherry.
And
so silly.
It beat Semisonic 29-19. Great voter turnout for Memorial Day weekend, guys. Really, really thank you on that one.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, and I got up and ran that. We ran that 5K the next day after I screenshotted at midnight. We ran that 5K. Did pretty well.
Is that the one you won?
For my age.
Hell yeah. That counts.
That counts.
We ran a lot of 5Ks.
Then I ran
weekend.
The other another 5K on Monday. Exact same time down to the second. Just creepy as fuck.
That is a little weird.
Okay.
You were a goosebump.
Was I a goosebump?
You ran the same exact time twice,
Speaking
different days,
of
different conditions.
Kind of looks like you just saw one.
Yeah. We also watched a lot of Goosebumps that weekend, and it's kind of gotten us into
Because the cable wasn't kick. Working. We're going to watch like a whole.
It turned out, I'm sorry for all of you. I mean, I think Emily listens, and I'm thinking of, trying to think of anybody else who listens who was at that, who came to the beach with us. But I definitely found out the day we left that I definitely just installed the box wrong. And that's why the cable didn't work. It was nothing wrong with the box. I just wasn't paying attention when I tried to put the wires in. And yeah, I fixed it easily.
Oh, wait. Did we miss 3 weeks?
I don't know.
We didn't do it for 2 weeks.
Yeah.
So it's 3 weeks of recap.
Oh, we didn't finish the Ichiro news. Sorry, Ichiro. Okay. You know, wouldn't it be so cool if Ichiro listened? Even though he doesn't speak English, he still has a translator.
He doesn't have Twitter. He speaks.
He speaks. True. He does make words.
He speaks a bit of English.
I think he still has a pretty strong translator. But anyway, Ichiro, for those who don't know, played for the Marlins for a long time. Went
Mariners.
To the Yankees. No, played for the... Oh, no, I'm sorry. You're absolutely right. Angela, you're right. Angela's right. Mariners, Seattle Mariners, started there, came from Japan. Then he went to the Yankees for a bit. Don't hold it against him. He's just trying to get paid. And now he's kind of living out the end of his days in Miami with the Marlins.
He's not going to die at the end. His end of his baseball day.
Maybe. But he rocks. He's doing so well. But what's important about him is that...
I get a little sad missing 2001 each year.
Missing him?
Yeah, like, heyday. Like, I want to go back to, like, the heyday.
Right now he's breaking all the records. In the heyday he wasn't breaking records.
Yeah,
he's chasing things now. Earlier he was a kid. But basically, Ichiro has a shit ton of hits. And he's closing in on 3,000 MLB hits, which isn't, like, he won't be the first player at all to do that. But it is pretty impressive, given that he spent, like, 7 years in Japan playing baseball. And if you take his bat, the hits he got in Japan with the hits he got in America, he'd be the major, he'd have the most hits in baseball history. And he dethroned Pete Rose, who's kind of this big jerk he's most notoriously known for betting on baseball.
That's all I know about that dude.
While he played it. So he was banned for life from baseball.
I'm sure I'd accidentally do that kind of shit.
But, I mean, I don't really care. That it's incredible that he has so many goddamn hits. Ichiro is number one.
Ichiro, number one. Okay, now...
That's all the sports talk, probably.
Yeah.
Probably.
Next. Okay. Then for Amy's birthday, we did the special videos featuring dudes dancing alone. Jamiroquai. It got close, man. Jamiroquai, great voter turnout, thank by the way, guys.
Shout out to all the voters. You're why we do this.
Jamiroquai, 34, beat Fatboy Slim. Weapon of choice, 27. Seven vote spread. This guy's falling.
That's because this microphone stand never really worked.
Ah.
Sorry if it gets really loud.
This microphone reminds me of the one they have at Sun Studios in Memphis.
Shout out Sun Studios. When are we going to do a live podcast from there?
Yeah, Elvis, why don't you ever come on here? Okay.
What if we broke the news that Elvis is still alive and he did our podcast first?
Elvis is still alive.
Punk rock is complicated.
Sorry, everybody. Angela just made herself laugh real hard.
Yeah, but Craig probably put some over top, man.
Yeah. Wouldn't it be cool if, from Parks and Rec, Perd Hapley, he did a Perd cast? That'd be so fun.
Oh, yeah.
I'm Perd Hapley, and I just realized I'm not holding my microphone.
Okay, sorry, gotta get to next...
All right, so we did the Eagle of Cherry, we did... Dudes dancing alone.
Last week was boxing.
You're missing all
boxing.
all these really good
you
boxing moves.
You know I can't
Angela.
Punch, and I don't like boxing.
Looks like you're doing Tai Bo.
I have.
What happened to Tai Bo?
Oh, Tai Bo is they still like that cardio kickboxing.
I mean, is that guy dead?
No.
Oh. Doesn't he kind of look like Seal?
I don't remember his face.
I don't either.
But
I just
cardio
think Seal.
Kickboxing. I mean, there's so many classes that are like it. Just Tai Bo's the brand. I used to do Tai Bo at the Burn Heights gym. Shout out Burn Heights gym.
Woo woo.
But maybe that's why I can't punch well, but you know I got the feet down. I'm not going to stand up and do it, but you know I have the foot motion for boxing, and don't tell them.
The word is footwork, but you do also, you have that foot motion down. Hell yeah.
Okay. Well, you didn't train in my gym. Okay.
It'd be cool if you taught dancing and you taught everyone to talk about, like, you got to get good foot motion.
You're making me laugh too much. I'm completely sober. All right. And with the boxing chicks, it was Alanis Morissette's You Learn Lost. She only got 13.
She lived, she learned.
Against.
Don't bring that weak shit against.
Yeah. Christina Aguilera is dirty. The chick boxing videos. She's all.
I'm overdue. What does that mean? I'm overdue. She's talking about banging? It's just a gross way to talk
dusty,
about your.
Like
yeah, just it's a really gross way to talk about your. Just like your. That's what I'm looking for. Your. Not sex metabolism. What is it? Like sex drive.
No sex with that one.
It's like I'm overdue for some sex. It's like it's not in your car. You don't have to take it in regularly.
Well, she got 29 votes.
She did.
Not as good of a voter turnout. I thought that would bring out the votes, but I had a really crazy morning, so I didn't post it till a little late, so I'll blame it on that. Okay. That's so much recap, man.
So much recap. Thanks,
yeah.
Everyone, for voting. Thanks for not getting too mad that we're not doing
if you're still
a podcast.
You're listening. God, thanks.
I'll be honest. I was kind of being a stick in the mud. And whenever we could have recorded, we weren't feeling well. There were some stressful things going on, so it just didn't pan out. And I apologize. I should commit more to making this happen. People like us doing it, and they're nice enough to listen. I should put forth a better effort to do it.
Yeah.
I'm over too.
Ew. Okay. So then, what else do we want to cover? I think we should cover my big pop music news. Can you check? Can you click on it to make sure I didn't mess up?
Sure.
The audio.
The podcast should be fine. Yeah, we're still rolling, baby. We're rolling.
Okay. Well, this fucking Gawker article. I'm sure y'all have seen it by now because it's like three people posted on my Facebook wall. If I hadn't clicked on it, you know, I don't read Gawker, okay?
We appreciate all of you guys waiting to get our hot take first, specifically Angela's hot take on this important news article, and not reading all the other pundits who might think they are an authority on the topic. That is, drum roll please, what's our story we're talking about, Angela?
I have to do the whole thing. So Gawker. Okay.
Gawker. That's not what the story's about.
Yeah, yes it is. Because my enemy right now is Gawker in this story. So. Okay.
All right, I think I'm confused of what we're talking about.
Yeah, so you'll find out with the rest of us. Okay.
Sorry,
so, buddy. I don't really read Gawker. I don't get it. I sometimes don't like their attitude. And then when I do go to their website, if I'm really bored, I'll type in Gawker.com. I go to Gawker. There's like 4 articles a day. I don't get how you get to go there for all your news because they don't have that many articles. So, I mean, on the main Gawker, I understand there's the other guys. There's the Deadspins and the Jezebels. I understand that. But Gawker.com has
that's
like
what I do.
4 articles a day. And one of them, one day, was written by this chick, Ashley Feinberg.
Calling you out, Ashley.
Calling you out. And so that's Smash Mouth. And Smash Mouth, I guess, on Twitter was like replying to haters or people saying, man, Smash Mouth only was a one-hit wonder. And a lot of these, okay. And some of these tweeters are like they clearly don't know much because they kept saying like, how does it feel that everyone only knows that one, only didn't know who you were before Shrek, which came out in 2001, okay? So it drove me insane. Oh my fucking God. You know what else drove me insane? That this
Ashley Feinberg?
No, this fucking article went away, so I'm going to stall until I can bring it up.
Ashley Feinberg, if you didn't think we were going to have a reaction to this, if you didn't think we were going to hear our hot take, we're spitting hot fire.
I mean, coming for you. I spit it on Facebook. I spit it on Twitter.
She spits hot fire. Flame emoji, flame emoji, like, flame emoji.
It just was like I was in the right sort of bad mood when I read this. I was like, and Smash Mouth's not my favorite band. I'm not close with them. Oh, I hope they throw bread at Ashley. I hope she wakes up in the middle of the night and he's standing over her with a loaf of bread. And I don't know the lead singer's name, but I know it's not fucking Guy Fieri. Okay, so first of all, she writes this article because basically Smash Mouth was responding to haters on Twitter with kind of funny things. Like someone would be like, how does it feel that your entire music career can be attributed to Shrek? Dumb shit like that. Smash Mouth said stuff like, yes, and we released All Star in 99. Already number ones on the charts before Shrek.
I'm pretty cool if they just responded with delete your account.
Yeah.
I'm a tight to the haters.
And then someone called him a one-hit wonder, and then he said, actually, we're a 6-hit wonder. 2 number ones. You wrong all the time?
Boom!
Oh, and for some reason in that tweet included Ted Cruz and Obama. I don't know why.
Hell yeah.
I
hope Ted Cruz is getting out of this. I gotta get a fight I can win. I'll just talk shit about Smash Mouth. And then he got smashed in his mouth.
I'm having trouble. Hey, Gawker mobile site sucks.
Yeah, all of the Gawker blog mobile sites really do
because,
suck.
Because, like, I'm not even finding...
The format's really, really fucked.
Okay, so, like, one person tweeted, I want someone to tell me that the first thing they think of when they hear this song is not Shrek, which is All Star. And Smash Mouth replied, at Lexiflow, we don't. We don't, since the song was already on its way to number one in every country in the world before the film was even finished. All right. Yes, because Shrek came out in 2001. All Star, everyone got sick of by August of 1999. I actually had to look this up, and I think that I couldn't find this stat. It used to be my favorite chart when I was little. It was the number one song played on the radio. The song was played the most times on the radio in a calendar year.
Oh.
Every year. So I know in 2000 it was Kryptonite, Three Doors Down.
You mean the Sole song of the year?
Yeah. Well, no, because it's lots of songs of the year. This is radio song of the year. The old Billboard
chart. 11-11.
The Billboard chart name used to be like hot song is like hot track of the year. Some shit like that. Anyway. 2001 was Lifehouse, Hanging by a Moment.
I'm falling
sort of thing.
Even more in love
I
with
actually
you.
Thought it was Smash Mouth 99. I think it might be, kind of has a timing. It might, I think, be No Scrubs or, excuse me, or Backstreet Boys. I want it that way, but anyway.
Tell me why.
But I looked this up because Smash Mouth has played almost that much. So Smash Mouth was number one, the number one song played on U.S. radio is like played more than any other song for 5 weeks from like August till September until Christina Aguilera kicked it off. I mean, that song was played all the fucking time. So if you don't know that song from Shrek, including this author fucking Ashley agrees with these tweeters, yeah, if you know that song because of Shrek, then you weren't allowed to listen to the radio. And I checked on TRL, it was on the charts for almost the entire summer was on TRL.
I understand.
It wasn't that well. It wasn't that high up. It was from Mystery Man's soundtrack, a movie that came out in 99.
Yeah. I understand why they would make that argument. I think because also when it's associated with a movie, that movie gets played again and again, but like the song's popularity went away. But they are factually wrong. And big ups to Smash Mouth for boom roasting the shit out of all the haters.
They're factually wrong and they're... that's an embarrassing opinion to have. If that's your opinion, you're not that educated on pop culture. You shouldn't be fucking tweeting about it. You're dumb. Don't embarrass yourself.
Looking at
yourself.
You, Ashley. Looking at you.
Don't embarrass yourself like that. Next, second of all, that Guy Fieri shit saying... That was maybe funny for a second, but I don't get when someone all of a sudden started making a joke because Guy Fieri had been a big guy for years. Smash Mouth had been over for years. And then someone puts it together. And now everyone thinks that's so funny. That's not even that fucking funny.
Well, I think...
Other people from that era look like Guy Fieri, too.
What I would say, I think you're being real, real specific on the way people view pop culture when it's... I think it's a lot more just in waves. I think, for whatever reason, the way it kind of shook out culturally, I think Smash Mouth has now fallen into the slot of, like, band that used to be popular now. Everyone wants to act like they were just a joke the whole time. Kind of like Creed. Not to say that Creed and Smash Mouth are on the same level. Smash Mouth is infinitely better. Smash Mouth Forever. That first CD rocked. A lot of ska on that CD. Pretty cool. But I think it's just falling into that place of pop culture where, like, they need, like, especially now, you need, like, a quote-unquote washed-up rock band from, like, 90s, 2000s to just be like, remember how we all just hated that band? And then I was like, no, remember how everyone loved that band and everything you're remembering is wrong? And I think that plays into the whole, like, the lead singer looks just like Guy Fieri. It's like, yeah, that's so funny. He does look just like Guy Fieri. And instead it just turns everyone making that damn joke over and over and over and over, and over again. That's what I think.
Yeah, can I read a quote from her fucking article?
Read it.
I want to know what year
Ashley,
she was born.
These are your fucking words.
She's either raised in a weird-ass household or she's born in, like, 94 or something. She should not be talking... I can talk about songs that came out when I was 5 years old because I'm educated when I do it. She's not.
Boom.
Okay.
Read a music book about 90s and 2000s music, Ashley.
I think she has to correct herself because this article is so misleading and wrong. In 97, when Guy Fieri and three of his friends released the hit single Walking on the Sun... They knew they'd finally made it. What they didn't know was that, blah, 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 that they'd be fighting Twitter eggs. As soon as Shrek, which featured All-Star heavily, came out in 2001, no one remembered Smash Mouth's earlier, less commercial hits. It skips over 1999 when they had, like, two hits from that. They had, like, two hits, I'd say, from that album because they had Then the Morning Comes. It's not as popular, but it's definitely people knew it. And All-Star was huge in 99. In 2001, only children, like, I remember, like, also, their biggest song from that movie was I'm a Believer.
That's, I was going to say, I think...
I didn't even know Smash Mouth, they, like, sing it for a second. Like,
I think everyone is getting confused. I think it might be a sort of, like, an almost Berenstain Bears situation.
She gets paid money to do this. That pisses me off. She gets paid money for this article.
This is a citizen's forfeiture of your salary,
Ashley.
Like,
they're already bankrupt, so I guess... Yeah. This is all they can
This is the kind of shoddy
afford.
Journalism that gets you taken to court.
You know, when I tweet out this podcast tomorrow, I'll tag Smash Mouth. I might be afraid to tag Ashley. Maybe I won't. Because Ashley posted another article today, and I'm not going to get into it, replying to the haters who sent her a mean email about this. But mostly she's like, oh, God. She only posts ones where, like, Guy Fieri is not in Smash Mouth. Like, come on. I'm sure there's smart people like me who are like, you're a fucking idiot. You should be embarrassed to write about pop culture. And then... Oh, so much. She didn't mention the bread festival. That's the funny shit. Talk about the bread festival. That is the funniest thing that happened to Smash Mouth.
Dude, Smash Mouth hated getting bread.
I went on a little Twitter rant, but I was busy at work. It wasn't that long. Smash Mouth liked two of my tweets because they know supporters.
Do you think they really hated the bread festival that much? Because they were all on diets where they can't eat carbs, and they felt they're gonna cheat. It's too tempting with all this bread being thrown at their faces.
Sometimes, okay, here's talking about Twitter people again. Sometimes they yell about the fact that they had a single before Shrek came out. A single. They had, like, four. They were on the Can't Hardly Wait soundtrack. They had a lot of fucking singles.
Hell yeah.
That they're not a one-hit wonder, but a six-hit wonder, a seven-hit wonder.
Well, how old do you think this girl actually was?
How does Smash Mouth count hits? Incredibly... I'm still reading. Incredibly loosely? That's not even fucking loose. As I talked about in my charts. Anyway, how old do you think she is? I don't know. Gawker, you have to be kind of old, but maybe not.
No, you don't have to be old.
You don't have to be that good.
You don't have to be anything on the goddamn internet now. You don't have to be shit. You don't even have to be in the same building.
Clearly. Yeah, she does try to... Anyway, that's over. We're going to this week. But I was very mad. Team Smash Mouth. Hope maybe they'll listen to this podcast whoever runs their Twitter account, since they seem to just look at themselves on
Twitter. They're going to start, and they're going to see that it's over, like, 50 minutes, and they're going to go, hell no.
I could tell them where to skip to. If they like my tweet, then I'll be like, skip to.
Okay.
And I'll skip them to this part.
I hope he didn't say anything offensive to Smash Mouth. I mean, I'm very Team Smash Mouth in all situations.
No.
I just, when bands, especially like when it's easy for like bands to get picked on, it's like, I don't like your music. If you're not doing anything, if you don't have like a, if you don't turn out to be like Ace of Base and have some neo-Nazis in there and there's some weird, like possibly like just hateful shit under the surface, it's fucking Smash Mouth. They've got, there's no political stance. They just want to make party tunes. They want to wear bowling shirts and sunglasses. And not even the cool sunglasses, like the wraparound Oakleys. Those aren't cool.
It's cool to them.
Sure. And they still have gel in their hair. And they want to fucking play bread festivals. And they just want to bring music to the people.
Hey, so I will say it's not a bread festival. It's like the Taste of Ontario, but they were giving
it. Was it in Canada?
I think it was.
I thought Canadians were supposed to be kind.
Maybe it wasn't, but they were giving out loaves of bread to everyone who walked into the festival, so it might as well have been. All right, we're going to move on to this week. Before that, I just noticed my right pinky toe, which has been a little sore from running, is completely bright red and covered in blisters. I might lose it, so we'll see. Hopefully I can keep it at the end of
this
podcast.
You're going
to
lose your toe?
I don't know,
the
yeah.
The entire thing?
I might. It's barely a toenail. All right.
Tune in to Toe Watch 2016.
All right, let's get into this week. Okay, I just got a mean text about Oprah. I'm not going to get into it. All right. This week's theme, I was saving it till we did a podcast, so I want to do a podcast, is Songs from Dawson's Creek Volume 1. Is my phone playing music?
Yeah, because...
I don't have anything open. Oh. Oh, it's Gawker. Okay. Well, fuck Gawker. All right. So now we're getting this week's... These songs are... First one is...
What's the theme?
It's Songs from Dawson's Creek, Volume 1. So there are songs that were on, like, from Dawson's Creek, and they put out an album for it.
Yeah.
The first one is going to be... Can we do Paul Cole's I Don't Want to Wait? Which is the theme song, because everyone thinks of Dawson's Creek. Versus Sixpence None the Richer, Kiss Me. So we're going to start this video over again.
Okay. Ain't no thing but a chicken wing.
We're going to start with Paul Cole. This song, in 98... It's like the most beautiful song on the radio for me. And you know, like whenever they have the memes, like, I look dramatically out the window when a song comes on and pretend I'm in a music video. I did that to this song so hard. Like, right. I had someone coming from World War II home to see me. All right, we're going to start it. 3, 2, 1.
Achoo! Play. Okay.
I'm getting chills already.
Already some imagery of time. Ooh, a lot of clocks. Because she doesn't want to wait? Is that what it is? So she's just staring
Probably.
At the clock the whole time?
Open up your morning. It's such a weird thing to say, isn't it? The song would give
Maybe
me
she
chills.
Just wants to make a coffee date. Song rocks. She's got some cool interpretive hand dancing. She also kind of dressed like she's in from the musical Hamilton.
Doesn't this remind you of the cowboy video?
Yeah.
Ooh, she is. I forgot.
Well, not
this
one. Now she looks like she's like a Roman.
Marie Antoinette or something.
Yeah.
Because that looks like Versailles. Who's this guy? He might
Creepy.
Be handsome, but the quality is so bad, I can't
And now
tell.
She looks like she's culturally appropriate in something. She kind of looks like Nelly Furtado.
She really
Oh, now
does.
She's now that guy's old.
Well, because there's a lot of stuff about old men and bullet wounds and stuff, so... This is a little dramatic for Dawson's Creek to be like... So, I didn't watch Dawson's Creek. Did you watch...
This is like a filter, like a one more darker filter on this from just being weird clips from the first season of True Detective.
Yeah, you're right.
So close.
So neither of us watched Dawson's Creek, but I have this thing where I'll get...
Pacey forever.
Drunk, and I'll come home, and I did this a lot in Boston, and I would be like, what happened on Dawson's Creek? And I go, and I read the episode summary of every episode, And then, like, so I get really into it by just reading that much detail, and then I get to the end, and I didn't like how it ended up.
What was Katie Holmes' character name?
Joey.
That's what it is. Pacey and Joey.
And then there's Dawson.
Fuck Dawson.
And she, like, hangs with Joey, but she stays with Pacey, but you can just tell it's not right. Like, they're not gonna last.
Are they banging teachers on that show?
Yeah, I think so. I think Blondie, Michelle Williams, who RIP her on the show.
She got killed?
In the finale. Oh, man, I'm always crying and drunk by the time I get to the finale episode. Because
of just reading the recaps, you're crying? That's some great episode recap writing.
Yeah, but then I will say, like, I only remembered it because I looked it up sober for this podcast, but I, every time, would then forget how it ends and have to reread the whole thing because I was always drunk when I read it.
I think this video was expensive.
This is about Marie Antoinette. Yeah.
So many costume changes. It must have taken so long to film.
It's just like,
you think
a
this
weird...
is all about Victorian sexuality?
No. Well, this wouldn't be the right...
Maybe there's, it's them talking to each other with... Because in the Victorian era, they just wore so many clothes.
Yeah.
And it was like, I don't want to wait to
little,
get these goddamn clothes
older.
Off
I mean,
so we can fuck.
Friend. I don't know. You don't take a class on Victorian sexual deviance. It's a beautiful song.
This is creepy. This video gives me the creeps.
So,
is she in the catacombs?
Yeah, because I feel like the video starts and it's changed eras a bit. Her head is so large.
She's getting that candle pretty close to herself, but it does give her great
light.
This
feels like Game of Thrones. See, where is she? What decade is this?
So that's when she's dressed like Hamilton. Oh, now there's World War One.
Oh,
she's a flapper.
She's 20s. Oh, I get it. She's like time. Oh, Will Charleston action there.
Whoa, she can shimmy.
I can't.
This is a, that's,
she can.
This is
she has
really,
a better body than I'd think.
This is a really weird... I just never imagined ever see Paula Cole dancing in a flapper dress.
I guess I've seen the video but haven't gotten this far.
They're really revealing. And I see the appeal. When they're like risque.
Well, that's not really... This is a little... This is, like, not right. They've
well, I bet
covered.
This is what they showed in, like the burlesque style ones where they're, like, dancing for dudes.
Well, didn't,
for
you watch, didn't you watch Boardwalk Empire?
Yeah.
What did they dress like?
I don't know. Kind of like that, but it looks more like... But doesn't she look like a Hamilton dancer?
I haven't... Yes. Yeah. Did Paula Cole do costume design for Hamilton?
You heard it here first. She just won a Tony. Alright.
Alright, so that's
initial
that.
Thoughts.
I like that video. I love that song. The video's a little weird. It
didn't
like,
really match the... I felt like the video did not match the song.
I always wanted a guy, a grandpa... I never had seen the video until I was older. Like, a grandpa to show up on the front porch, soaked in rain, and he has shrapnel in his skin. And I will say a guy walked in the graveyard, but that was different, and I wanted that to happen.
Is it the line, the first line, open up your morning light?
Probably, but I...
That makes less sound than open up your morning just sounds like you're trying to make some, like, arrange some coffee date. Can you open up your morning?
I do like that. I want to start saying that every morning when I wake up. Open up your morning now.
All right, so our second video we got coming up. Y'all know it. It's a classic.
I got some interesting stuff to say about this. Sixpence on the Richer. Starting... So, interesting about this, I've been waiting to say, is there are two versions of this video, and that's because this was also on the... She's All That soundtrack.
Yeah.
And so there's a...
I know this song from She's All That way more than from Dawson's.
Walks down the street, but there's a the steps. There's a version where in the video on the TV, they're watching their clips from She's All That, and there's also a Dawson's Creek one. I pulled up the Dawson's
TV
Creek
working?
One. I don't know. See, there's Dawson working,
yeah.
But in the other version, it's Rachel Lee Cook.
They really should kick the guy out of the band. He's not doing anything. He's playing the... accordion, we got a guitar.
He's holding the TV.
This is just watching TV.
He might
engage with your bandmates.
Hey, to be fair, maybe he's not in the band. Maybe they got on this guy's bench.
Maybe he's just pissed. He's trying to watch Dawson's Creek, and this fucking band is screaming in his ear.
Look how cute her little hair is in her dress.
In my head, I always forget what this band looks like and the cardigans. I know the cardigans are foreign, but in my head, these are band is the exact same thing. Whoa, Pacey's making out with Michelle Williams.
The other thing about Dawson's Creek is that there's a line, 10 things I hate about you, where the dad... I can only quote some movies. Where the dad says, I don't want you... I see what those Dawson's Creek kids do, sleeping in each other's bed and everything, so I figure that must happen on the show. I have seen the first episodes
doesn't
of Dawson's
Joey
Creek.
Doesn't Joey just do it once in
I don't know,
Dawson's bed?
Because I've only seen two episodes,
where the
but
fuck does Dawson get off having his own damn creek?
Let me finish. I don't know if it's... It is like... Does he
also
go there?
Also, it looks more like a lake. It doesn't look like a creek.
It is probably technically a creek. I don't know why I call it Kids Creek. But so, in the very... I've only seen, like, the pilot of Dawson's Creek. And in the pilot, the very first scene, Joey is sleeping in Dawson's bed. So I'm like, ah, so maybe he's just seen the pilot, too, because that does happen on that show right away.
She's really cute.
She's really cute. Who?
The main girl. Michelle Williams is just a legit babe. That's a lot of teenagers kissing in this video.
Yeah, Katie Holmes was real cute.
Yeah.
In this part.
Oh, does she play guitar?
What is TV guy doing now?
I bet he's a drummer. Drummers are always those quirky guys in the band. Oh.
What kind of facial hair? Does he have Guy Fieri facial hair, or does he have Smash Mouth facial hair? Because they have the reverse. His has the gap in the middle, so is that Guy Fieri?
No, it's just a chin beard.
No, but one of them... I'll look it up. This is a very green video.
Oh. That was weird. We had a break in the action. Technical difficulties.
And maybe that wasn't the full video.
Did it really just stop? Is it over?
Okay. Alejandro Marcelo, you're on my bad list for uploading an incomplete video.
We'll try one more time.
We'll just skip to...
It could be a bunch of different things. I'm going to take it off. I'm going to get it off the big TV. We can watch it on the laptop, see if that stops. Makes it any better. Oh, I don't think it is. I think it does just end abruptly. Sorry for the new sound.
Fuck you, Alejandro. We could go to the other version, but...
Maybe, let's see. It's definitely longer than 2 hours, 2 minutes, 24 seconds, right?
Yeah, but probably not.
Oh, it is. No, it does. It just stop abruptly.
Oh my god, Alejandro.
Alejandro, you fucked us over.
Let's press the back button.
It really shows how much research we do before this.
Well, I checked to make sure it worked. So go back one more.
320. This is probably it.
That's... Okay.
Let's try this one. Thanks for working with us, everybody.
Okay, Pollyanna Ewelton. So we're skipping back to...
Alright, so we're about 2 minutes, 20 seconds in.
4. Okay. Oh, there's his beard again. Like, nice sideburns. She's a cutie. I wonder if she dated
anyone. She
looks
like a lead singer of Paramore.
She does. Haley Williams looks like her. I always thought that, actually.
Yeah, that's fair.
Ooh, now they got a bigger TV. It's like an outdoor movie situation.
Everyone in her band is giving her kisses.
She kisses. She's singing to kiss me. They're finally like, shut up.
Was this a really big wedding song when it came out?
Should have been, but people probably... People make bad wedding song choices. I'm not going to say any more on that, but...
Yeah.
Do you want this to be a wedding song? It's a good one.
You mean like for like a first dance? Or just like play it at a wedding? I mean, play it at a wedding would be fun for a slow
instead
dance.
Instead of
slow
vows?
Dance,
what if instead of vows, you just play the song and you kiss at the end?
You could use yours. I am still doing Ja Rule's...
Put on me?
Yeah. That's going to be my... Those are going to be my wedding vows.
Don't tell me.
Okay.
I don't know who you're going to marry, but she better be into that. All right, so what do you think?
I think I got to go with Sixpence and None the Richer.
Me too. That video is more fun. I love the green lighting and I love the green filter.
It's the hue, yeah.
A video makes me so happy. That song makes me
Can
so happy.
Can we learn where their name comes from?
It's from a book.
I'll do the typing. I'll do it.
I just read it. It's some book. I mean, are they Irish? I don't know. Oh my gosh.
Tennessee.
They're Christian.
Oh no.
Do you know they're a Christian band?
Also known as Sixpence. They dropped Another Richer part.
There She Goes cover's really good.
Who did the original There She Goes?
I know, but there's a British band. I don't know if it's the original one. It's like the Wah something. The something Wah.
That is kind of a bummer that their genre is Christian rock.
Well, that Kiss Me, is that like supposed to be like Jesus Kiss Me?
No, that's just trying to get paid.
Oh, well, their name is from a passage in a Christian book.
Oh, C.S. Lewis. That's the guy who did Wine, Lunch, and Wardrobe, right?
Oh, yeah, he's a Christian as fuck, man.
Yeah. From the book Mere Christianity.
Alright. Origin of the band's name. Formation. Well... I'm glad we agree on that. I like Paul Cole. That was my favorite song in 98.
Thought the video did not match the song itself, though. And it was super creepy. Really gave me some vibes.
I mean, I guess there's time
Expected. Oh, even more about time. I didn't even put that together. That's very first season of Turned Out a Murderer.
Do you think that inspired True Detective?
True Detective?
Huh.
I'm kind of bummed out that the McConaissance is over. Because I love Matthew McConaughey. And it seems like he's finally starting to fizzle out. He's not in everything. Although he does have another movie that's probably going to get a lot of backlash. Because it's about a white dude who saves all the black slaves. But I still love Matthew McConaughey. He was still going to We Are Marshall.
Yeah, man. We watched that movie.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah, it's a movie I'd wanted to see for years, and I finally got my shit together. Very sad that plane crash.
Tragic.
Okay, so he was going to We Are Marshall? I will say We Are Marshall was like, it felt like it was missing. Like.
Yeah, no, I think it was missing like one big part that really brought it together.
And instead think, it was just like, oh, I coached your team. I don't know.
It's kind of messed up, but I feel like one of the bigger parts of it was like, it kind of seemed disjointed. It kind of seemed like the players didn't really care that much. Like, yeah. there should have been more about, like, the guy who's now Falcon in the Marvel movies. Mm-hmm. He plays, like, one of the only returning players who didn't die because he wasn't in that plane.
Yeah.
And, I think it should have been more focused on him, like being like, holy crap, we're back, we did it. And the other part is, like, of, like, the Star Captain's girlfriend, the captain died, and it's the woman, what's her name? She was in Blue Crush and all that, wasn't she?
I forget who plays. Oh, Alex Skarsgård is a David. Kate Bosworth?
Yeah, I think it's Kate Bosworth. Like, it sounds kind of messed up. It's like, she really should have had, like, a love interest, but she really didn't. Like, it just kind of ended up being disjointed. It's just still more tragic than, like, that doesn't ever, like, come back and hit you in the heart in a good way. It's a little kind of thing of, like, oh, she's still really sad.
Yeah.
But it's a good movie.
Yeah, so, anyway, yeah, I agree. And it's like they fudged stuff. They made it more like inspiring the way he became their coach. Like they made it like he just read it in a newspaper. So they lied about that. They could have lied about more to make the movie more of a.
And I'm all about like especially if you're gonna make a movie for something, just tell some tales and make the story better. I'm into that. Every once in a while, when I'm telling a story, if I think if there's a better way to tell it, even if it's not true, I'll say it. It's all about telling the story. It's all about storytelling.
Yeah. Back real quick, one thing I need to add about I Don't Want to Wait is that song I like so much was actually the reason I was so furious when Sunny Came Home swept the Grammys. I woke up because I didn't realize that it was Where Have All the Cowboys Gone was actually the song nominated for Song and Record of the Year. When I found that out, I wasn't as angry. So it's just something, you know, something I talk about a lot that I need to get off my chest. So I think that's everything I wanted to talk about.
Isn't that kind of interesting? Now I'm thinking about Sunny Came Home. No, I'm thinking of Where Have All the Cowboys Gone and I Don't Want to Wait. That I Don't Want to Wait starts with...
Open up.
No, how does this look?
Open up your morning like, say a little...
Okay, that was not the tune whatsoever.
I can't do tunes, don't ask me.
How does it... I Don't Want to Wait start again?
You just play it, so...
Oh, yeah, because now it threw me off from... Because Where Have All the Cowboys, and it's, it's just similar to some acapella songs. I think she was in an acapella band. What would Paula Cole's acapella pun band be called?
You know I can't come up with puns. You gotta give me a day. Okay, so what, do I think of her songs or something?
Well, it's gotta be like, I don't know, I'm trying to think of Paula Cole. Acapella Cole. Not bad.
Is that a pun?
Hell yeah. You want to start an acapella Paula Cole cover band called Acapella Cole?
Well, you know what's funny? What I said when I was drunk, I think probably when me and Carl were really serious about the Lopez Fitzgeralds, our band.
When you were really serious.
I told,
so close to finally putting pen to paper, writing some hits.
When I get drunk, I would tell people... When they asked what I was going to sound like, when they were humoring me, I would say, it's a Paula Cole response band. So we are going to, our songs will answer the question of where have all the cowboys gone? And something about, like, waiting. And that was...
Ooh. Maybe she wrote this while she was bored. Maybe she worked a morning diner shift. And that's just, like, open up your morning light. Like, they're talking about drawing back the curtains. And she doesn't want to wait. And wait is like kind of a play on words because she doesn't want to wait tables. And she feels like she's wasting away.
Maybe
and Margaritaville.
It's written about Shelley from Twin Peaks.
Shout out Shelley from Twin Peaks. You are a babe.
Hot.
And I'm in love with you. And I don't... But she would never go for me because she has terrible taste in men.
Oh, Bobby. great taste there. She doesn't handle Bobby well. Leo's terrible.
Leo's
choice.
Awful.
Yeah.
Bobby's just a punk little kid.
Yeah, but
she's very foolishly trusting him to like, take care of her.
Screw. She's pretty dumb.
Great for a screw. Angela talks.
Do we have any commercials? I don't know. Craig will find some commercial. What do we shout? We shout it out.
Ooh, can you play, Craig, if you can find the theme song / commercial for that the really cool tabletop board game called CROSSFIRE. It had a really, really awesome theme, like I don't want to call it theme song. Jingle? Yeah, jingle. But do you remember CROSSFIRE? I used to watch it on, don't get mad, it was always on like Nickelodeon and the Disney Channel. It was a game you could play. It looked like, it was almost like a mini air hockey table. But each side you played against had like a little gun, like a tiny little gun built into the board game.
I never played
that
game.
But you shot little ball bearings towards all these spinners on the field, and you were trying to hit these little spinners on this like mini air hockey table into the opponent's goal. No, it was pretty small. It was like this, maybe a foot and a half long.
I've never seen that in my
life. It looked
like
a miniature, and it kind of felt like, it was kind of like the opposite of Hungry Hippos. You're trying to shoot shit into the opponent's
I'll tell you that I'm
goal.
Sure I
Instead
saw those.
As opposed to eating the ball bearings, just shoot them.
I'm sure I saw those commercials, but it probably wasn't something that would attract me, and I don't think I knew anyone had it, so I never played.
It's got an awesome jingle, Craig. If you find it, I'd love you forever. I still love you forever, Craig. Craig, you're the best.
You are, Craig. Speaking of which, I think we should say sorry and wrap up. So.
Yeah, let's get some apologies.
So, are you sorry to anyone?
I want to apologize on behalf of Planet Earth to Smash Mouth, that everyone fronting and acting like you guys didn't have legit hits well before Shrek. And I think that they were getting... I think everyone got confused because All-Star was definitely, over time, bigger than I'm a Believer. But the video from I'm a Believer is nothing but Shrek. Because it's from Shrek.
I think of Mystery Men when I think of All-Star.
I just think of all sports using All-Star. When that summer, every All-Star game played All-Star. It became just a staple in every arena and stadium. Everyone
it
played All-Star.
Us, our generation about global warming. I honestly didn't know what global warming was until the second verse of that song.
Yeah. And then we got our graduate degree in global warming from the Postal Service.
So what?
What everyone was like, now we can swim any day in November. Sleeping in, that song. It's all about global warming.
Okay, well, I'm not that up on the Postal Service. I know a bit.
Other people to apologize to. Certainly not.
Not Ashley.
Not Ashley.
I guess I should...
Journalistic integrity. Find some.
I was mean about your bankruptcy, Gawker, but don't pay... people like this to write about stuff like this. It's just bad, you know? Yeah.
It's a bummer that with their bankruptcy,
the whole lawsuit,
it wasn't for a more worthy cause. I mean, it sounds like you got screwed over, but
like the
Gawker
smash
is
mouth
kind of trash.
All right, so,
enjoyable trash, but trash.
Anything else to say? I don't know. I'm not sorry.
Craig, hopefully at this point you've already played the Biebs. And, I mean, it's never too late to say sorry. So how about we challenge you, the listener? Why don't you shoot us an email to our email account? Angela, what is it?
TRL Friday podcast.
About an apology that you gave somebody you may have wronged and you didn't necessarily apologize. Go apologize to that person and send us an email about it.
Maybe I should have a contest. Like the best email about blank will get a prize.
Yeah. Also, if you can get any documented proof that you went up to the person you wronged, or persons, and you asked first if it's too late to say sorry.
Okay,
that would be cool.
This is complicated, but I want to go with the email contest and then have it and then there'll be a prize. All right. Goodbye to you. Play us out.
Play us out. For all you branch heads, next week's our week. And as always, Angela and I say goodbye to you, and I promise it won't be 2 weeks till you hear from us again.
Peace out, peace frogs. Out, donut. We are back, Mrs. D. Achoo!